has historically been a trusted language for the scientific community. It's an easy-to-learn general programming language, it has a rich set of interactive tools for exploration and research, and it has great foundational libraries in mathematics and science. We have seen Python being used in large-scale applications. We have seen Python being used in scripting and automation of production environments. But in reality, we haven't seen Python adoption as a first-class language in organizations.
Thoughtworks has long promoted the idea of polyglot programming, where you choose the programming language that's most appropriate for your problem. Python is a good language for data science and AI research, as well as other kinds of scientific computation, because of the strength of its libraries.
Recentemente, Python tem ampliado seu uso fora do meio acadêmico, em ambientes embarcados como Raspberry Pi, ou em ambientes de operações. Já há algum tempo, operações utiliza Python ao invés de Shell Script ou Perl como ferramenta de controle de infraestrutura. Mas além disso, há bibliotecas e ferramentas em Python para teste de infraestrutura, configuração de servidores e até na plataforma Lambda da Amazon, ou seja, uma arquitetura serverless feita em Python.
Right now, there is a great interest and growth in Python AI ecosystem. Our tech radar is a good indication of that. We have TensorFlow and Airflow as graph-based execution engines that aim at unifying the production and development tooling. We have Spacy as a natural language processing library that is directed for real-world production use. And there is Keras as a pluggable deep learning library in Python.
Performance has been an issue, as has been concurrency. But now, with the new release of Python, many of those concerns have been addressed.
Python 3 gets around this problem for I/O-bound applications by introduction of async I/O. So that answers the performance issue for majority of the applications we build.
In addition, with the advent of data analytics being such a key part of most enterprises, data scientists and software engineers are working more closely together.
Microservices and container technologies are closing the gap between research and development. A data scientist can use a Python container image to explore and research and model on his development environment, while an engineer can deploy the same image to test a production environment. By encapsulating a Python model in a microservice, deploying it as a container, and exposing its capabilities as language-agnostic APIs, we can remove the friction that has always existed between research and engineering.
Recentemente, nós temos visto o uso de containers para empacotar pacotes de análise de dados e inteligência artificial. Corporações que têm interesses nessas áreas vão eventualmente adquirir pacotes em Python. Portanto, o know-how de Python dentro dessas corporações vai ser necessário.
The use of Python as a production language in these enterprises is allowing the data scientists and researchers to do their exploratory modeling and have those models be put into production.